Look at the big picture. We see the skies have cleared, obviously, throughout the area, or for the most part, they've cleared. Here was the cold front coming through, a few scattered showers, and kaboom, our temperature dropped 10, 15 degrees right around the noon hour for the day today as that cold air moved on through, but has moved on in, and again, the cold front has moved on out. We're still left with some wind near the shorelines, farther inland. That wind should drop off significantly, drop on down about 10 miles an hour, but it'll still be 20 miles an hour near the shoreline coming up by tomorrow morning. Now, I tend to think these raw numbers in the inland area is a little bit too mild. I think it'll be around 24, 25 inland, around 30, 32 degrees near the shoreline coming up by tomorrow morning. During the day tomorrow, low 40s, around 40, 43. Here's where things are by 7 o'clock in the evening. Not as much wind by the afternoon hours of tomorrow. Now, snow, what are we looking at for that coming up on Sunday? It doesn't look like it's going to happen. We can see a flake or two of snow, but right now, it just looks like a little bit of cloud cover through the area and clearing even in the afternoon, 38, 40. If we do see any snowfall into the entire region, it would be farther southward toward the Albemarle Sound in northeast North Carolina. By 7 o'clock Sunday evening, again, it's temperatures generally around 40 degrees, 38, 39, 40 degrees. Now we're going to show you two different forecast models and what each one of them thinks, quote unquote, is going to happen for Monday night and Tuesday. This one by Monday evening at 7, 42, 41, and it just updated here during the latter part of the day. It's got this low pressure area at 2 o'clock in the morning. This is not snow. This is rain, heavier rainfall in the blue color. And the low pressure area climbing northward right on in over the top of us by Tuesday morning at 7 o'clock. Now, once this moves out to sea, we see more of a west and northwesterly wind, and there could even be some snow on up toward the Richmond area, certainly for points northwestward, on up toward Charlottesville. And there it moves on off, and so by 10, 11 o'clock in the morning, that rainfall is tapered on off. We see rather windy conditions for the area, but again, it looks like the rainfall should come to an end with that one. I'm going to show you a different one here and show you what's going on. This one's called the Euro. Monday evening at 7, pretty much agrees, 44, 46, a little bit warmer toward the Richmond area, but it's going to have the storm developing right on down into here. You can start to see the curve and the wind streamlines. And this one is the Euro, and it takes some of that winds stronger offshore. Now, with the storm being offshore, it's going to be a stronger storm. We end up with more of a northeasterly wind. We end up with some colder air toward the Richmond area, and again, snow to the northwest of Richmond coming up by Tuesday morning, and they could see heavier snow. Now it moves on out to sea, intensifies significantly. You can see the winds just dropping on through the area. But with this one, during the morning hours, we could see some tidal flooding out of this one if it holds true with more of a northeasterly wind, and then winds becoming more northerly and northwesterly, some colder air by Tuesday during the afternoon hours, and there could certainly be more snowfall toward the Richmond area, and it continues. Or remember the other one gets rid of the rainfall by around 10, 11 o'clock in the morning. This one continues it into 7 o'clock in the evening. We'll watch that one very, very carefully. Lots of time yet. We're 5 days away from that one, so we've got plenty of time to watch for that one. For Sunday, flurries, yeah, could happen. This would be the worst-case scenario. A few flurries, maybe a dusting on the grass farther southward, so I'm not real concerned about Sunday whatsoever. Other than the fact it's going to be cold, 43 degrees. It'll be windy overnight or breezy overnight and into the first part of the day on Saturday. Wind should drop off. Remember to move your clocks forward coming up on Saturday night, Sunday morning at 2 o'clock. A few flurries mainly south. See some rain late in the day on Monday and into the day on Tuesday. Watching that one carefully for signs of development out to sea.